Everything we've done so far has been to set up the rules of the game. We defined a network and the notion of a flow over it, and we justified some of the simplifications that we've made. Now we're going to turn to the task of actually finding a maximum flow. The search will be an incremental one. We'll start with a suboptimal flow, and then we'll look for a way to increase it.
Suppose that we are given a particular flow over a network, and we want to explore how we might change it. Perhaps we realize that we can increase the flow by routing it through this link here instead of through these two. And that would then allow us to add more flow through this path. This is equivalent to adding a flow that goes like this. Notice that the flows through the middle cancel out. By adding this flow to the original, I get the desired result. Alternatively, if we just wanted to reroute the flow through the top link, we could add a circular flow like this, which would then reroute the flow. In fact, all possible changes that we might make to our original flow can be characterized as another flow, but different rules apply. Certainly, if we've used up some of the capacity on an edge, we can't use the full capacity in the flow we're going to add. We capture the rules for the flow that we are allowed to add with the notion of a residual flow network. We start by defining the residual capacity for all pairs of vertices. Let's consider a UV edge. If UV is an edge in the original graph, then the residual capacity is the original capacity minus whatever flow we already sent across that edge. For reverse edges, where not UV but VU is the edge in the graph, then we have a capacity equal to the flow that we sent from V to U. We can unsend this much flow. Everywhere else, the residual capacity is zero. In the residual graph, the edges are those UV pairs for which the capacity is positive. Keeping the network sparse helps in the analysis. In this example here, notice how the direction of this edge is reversed. There's no residual capacity going forwards anymore. That's all been used up. But there is a residual capacity going backwards, since we can unsend the unit of flow that we sent up here. This edge here remains the same. We can still send one unit of flow along there. This edge in the middle gets interesting because we can either send one unit of flow that would still leave us inside of these capacity constraints here, or we can unsend the unit of flow that we already sent.